Hey loves, it's Adanna here and welcome back to my channel. So how are you guys all doing? So today, y'all, going to be doing something that I never thought I could do, and I'll be sharing this with you guys. So this is my very first time for me doing fixing my nails by myself. Thanks to quarantine and this whole lockdown, like I literally have no experience with this. However, I did the first hand, as you guys can see. I already did my, what is it called? My left hand, and I posted it on Instagram. You guys really liked it and wanted a tutorial on it. And I was like, oh, thank goodness, I haven't done my right hand yet. So I just decided to film my right hand for you all while we do this video together, okay? First of all, I need to put it out there, you all, like I was actually struggling a lot with my right hand because I'm right-handed, so it felt really awkward. Yeah, it was just very weird. But I believe if I keep doing it, I'll definitely get used to it at some point. First thing I did, like you guys already saw, was to take down my previous nail polish. I had, you know, polished my natural nails like a pinkish properly. So I took that out with some acetone and aluminium foil, like you guys saw in the beginning. So right now, I'm just going to go ahead to start gluing these nails. So these are some very old nail tips that I had from like 3 years ago when I was in uni. So I got them then so I could start doing my nails by myself and I could save some money. But, you know, I just never had the time to use it and I just never even did the nail thing again. So as you guys can see, it's currently fresh out of the bag. And I just went ahead to, you know, grab each one, fit it to my hand, make sure that it's the right fit. And then I cut the edges so I could get the coffin shape. I just used the scissors to cut it because I just thought it was going to be a lot easier for me as I currently did not even have the nail clipper thing. I didn't have that, so I just used what was available for me. And then after gluing down the nails, I went ahead to trim it down again to the perfect length that I wanted it to be while making sure that it was, you know, the same length as my other hand. And then right now I'm just going to go ahead to start filing just so I could get like the coffin shape that I was going for. I'm not really exactly sure what I'm doing, but based on my experience from going to the nail salon, I observe my nail tech Helen whenever she's doing my nails. So I'm just trying to, you know, retreat what I normally see her do. So after gluing the nails right now, I'm currently filing. This is actually the main work for me. However, when I was shopping on Amazon for like other nail styles, I also discovered like you could actually get the nail tips in coffin shape or like pointy. So you could get nail tips that are already shaped up for you. So that's what I'm going to do next time because I don't think I want to have to file this. It took me a while to file this. This whole nail, like this one hand, literally took me 3 hours. But then again, it could also be because I'm new to it. So I just kept on filing. I'll be sure to put the link to like every single product I used in this video down in the description box. So this nail file was a whole set. It came from Amazon as well. So yeah, I'm just going to keep on filing. And once I'm done filing and getting the shape that I want, as you guys can see, then go ahead to file the surface of the nail just to give it that rough texture because apparently, if you want to be able to stick on gel on a surface, the surface has to be kind of rough just so the gel sticks on properly based on all the YouTube videos that I watched before trying this out. So now that I've filed that down and giving that a rough surface look while also making sure that the entire surface of each nail is all leveled together and all in alignment. Also forgot to mention that this nail file actually came in the set of the UV lamp. So there was a nail file, like 4 of them, 4 different sizes, and a little brush, as well as that feet. That stuff they used to put on your feet when you want to separate the feet apart from each other. I don't really know the name of that thing, but you guys know what I'm talking about. Those little, it's kind of like foamy thing they put in your feet when they want to separate your feet so the nail polish doesn't overlap each other. Yeah, so that also came in the kit with the UV lamp as well as this nail file. So now that I'm done filing these nails, I'm just going to go ahead right now to prime my nails. So this is a nail primer. It's just like a surface to allow your nail products like the gel and everything to adhere on. So I'm going to use this to prime my nails. Just the way you have like your foundation primer. You know what I mean? Exactly. Just to give it that base, you know. Also got this Amelie primer from Amazon. I don't know if I said the brand correctly, but it's spelled A-I-M-E-I-L-I. And then right now, I'm just going to go ahead to cure it for 60 seconds. So all the curing I did was for 60 seconds. I don't know if there's anything like too much curing. So if you're a nail tech, please let me know down below if there's anything like too much curing or... Yeah, I don't really know. I just said 60 seconds and I was just doing everything 60 seconds. Now moving on to the nail pH bonder. So this also helps to balance the pH of the nails. And I just applied this after applying the primer. And this also helps to adhere the gel to your nails just so everything lasts pretty long. My friend who is a nail tech, shout out to Danny. I'll be sure to leave her Instagram down below in the description box. She's based in Toronto. She gave me like a list of all the products that I will basically need for this entire process. So after curing the bonder as well for 60 seconds, right now I'm going to go ahead to use the IBB UV clear gel. So I actually kept building up this gel to give it that thickness, so my nail will be kind of thick, not too thick, but like so it's strong enough and it doesn't move. I didn't want to do acrylic because Danny advised that since I'm new to this, it would be best for me to do gel because it's a lot easier for a beginner compared to acrylic. So I decided to go for like the gel. So I kept building this gel. This gel actually moves. So that was also a good thing and a bad thing because I found out that you don't really have to try so much to smoothing out the gel. It sort of balances itself around just depending on how you move your fingers. It just balances around. But the other thing is, of course, it might balance a lot to one side than the other. But you just keep moving your fingers around, it will balance well across your entire nail bed. So I just kept applying this gel onto every single nail, building this up and making sure that, you know, it's staying on really nice and good. I also feel like this nail brush was very, very helpful when it came to building up this gel on my nail bed. So this is the number 6 medium hair brush. I also got this off of Amazon. So I'll be sure to put the link. Don't worry, I'll put the link. So one thing I was also doing was taking my time to actually do these nails because I didn't want to have to put the gel on all of them, like all of my 5 fingernails. So I did the first 3 and then I cured it and then I brought my nails out and then did the gel again on the last 2 just because like the longer I left it on and kept moving my hand around while trying to apply the gel on the next nail, you'll find out that the builder gel keeps moving. So once you feel like you've gotten that perfect shape and where you want the builder gel to stay, the buildup is perfectly fine, just cure it and keep going slowly. Take your time, don't worry, no rush. Also, if you put your hand inside the UV lamp and you feel like a little bit of burn or sensation, just take your fingers out and clean up the edges because it means that the nail products got on your skin. So the nail gel on your skin is what is actually causing the sensation. So just take it out, clean it up, and then put it back. After doing the first layer, I'm just going to go ahead to build up the second layer. So I did this twice. So I did the first build up and then I did the second build up just so it's easier for everything to dry when I put it inside the UV lamp. I didn't want to build up everything all at once. It would just be a lot. So this just allowed the entire process to dry very nicely and perfect. And also, this is my first time actually doing gel nails because all the time when I go to the nail salon, I always do acrylic. So, but I feel like it's pretty much similar application process. However, the difference I noticed is that the gel nails is actually a lot softer. So it's not as hard as acrylic. And that makes it a lot easier to take off when it's time to take it off. And also, it's a lot healthier for your natural nails. And I feel like I would definitely be doing my nails by myself right now because I feel like it's more hygienic, like you're using your own products on your own nail. So it's more hygienic and also, and it's a lot more cost effective, very economical. Like you save a lot of money, literally. I'm basically done building this entire gel. I'm going to go ahead right now to start filing because when you put on the gel, it, like I said, it moves a lot. So sometimes it's not even like surface perfect or smooth. There could be some bumps here and there. So I'm going to go ahead to start filing, making sure that the shape is maintained because sometimes it also affects the shape of the nail that you were initially going for because like I said, it moves. For this particular process, you could also use a nail drill if you have one, but I wasn't sure how comfortable I felt using a nail drill for this part. For me, I only use the nail drill when it's time to take off my gel nail. So I just use it to take off the surface of the gels. But for this part, I decided to just manually file because I don't know what I was doing, okay? So now we have a rough surface, perfect for like the nail gel polish adherence. So right now I'm going to go back again to using my pH bonder. If you're a nail tech, please let me know. I'm not really sure if I was supposed to put a pH bonder at this point, but because I felt like I was going to apply a gel polish and my friend told me that this is going to help your nails last longer, just putting this every time that I felt I was going to put any form of gel on top of my nails, I'll make sure that I put the pH bonder first just because I want these nails to last long. It's still lasting pretty long. I've had it for 2 weeks right now and you know, it's still rocking all good and fine. And then after applying the pH bonder, I went ahead to cure my nails for 60 seconds as well. And then right now I'm just going to go ahead to apply my base coat right before we start off with the nail polish. So this base coat is from AliExpress, and also the nail polish color that I'm using is also from AliExpress. This is the Lemovac. Okay, I'll just put it on the screen. It's a brown chocolatey nail polish. I got it off of AliExpress, like I mentioned. I just love the fact that it suits my skin tone. It's just like, you know, like the color of my skin, very chocolatey, and I'm like, I'm here for this, you know, that's melanin. I've always wanted to try like a nude nails, but every time I go to the nail salon, I just get overwhelmed by colors and I end up not trying this. So this time when I had to order my nail colors by myself, you know, I was just very specific. I wasn't really overwhelmed by colors. I kind of knew what I was going for. So I applied a thin layer of this gel polish on my nails, cured it for 60 seconds. And then after curing for 60 seconds, I took it out and then applied the second layer again just to build up this gel a little bit and also to give it that pigmentation as well. And then I went ahead to cure it again for another 60 seconds. And after I was done, I wanted like a little, like, you know, a little bit of decoration on my ring finger, this particular one here. So I went ahead to use my eyeshadow. So this is my glitter eyeshadow. I just poured the eyeshadow on the surface of this nail while I had the little plates down there. That's the lid of this eyeshadow. I just poured it right there. I also got this eyeshadow from AliExpress about 3 years ago, so it's pretty old. I poured it there, rubbed my fingers through just to make sure that this entire glitter is properly covered on this nail bed. And then right now I'm going to go ahead over top of that to apply my gel UV nail gel builder again. And I just belt this gel on top of this nail bed just so this glitter stays in place and just to hold it down as well. You don't have to press, don't try to rub, try to like tap over it just so it stays without moving the glitter all around. So just tap the gel over top while building it, and then I cure this again for 60 seconds. Brought it out, then filed it just so I could smooth out this builder gel. Filed it and make sure that, you know, I also reshaped the nail just to keep the entire coffin shape in place. Honestly, you guys, AliExpress has like really good nail polish, also very affordable. Like, you guys, I got this nail polish for $1. Like, yeah, $1. And it's so good. It hasn't chipped. It's been 2 weeks. It's just perfect. Also, this particular part that I just did right now, I wasn't really sure if I was supposed to do that, to be honest. I used alcohol to wipe off the surface of my nail because there was like so much dust around, but I'm not really sure if that part was necessary. But if you're a nail tech, please let me know down below in the comment section. And then right now I'm going to go ahead to finalize everything using my top coat. This top coat is also from AliExpress. I applied this just right on the surface of the nail to bring back that shine and then cured it again. And then once I was done with this entire thing, the second to last thing that I did was to use my nail polish remover to clean up this nail, to make sure that, you know, nothing is moving, to make sure everything is dry, and to see what I currently have done and to know if there's anything that has to be fixed. And yeah, and then I used my cuticle oil. I got this one off of Amazon. This is the But yes, I just applied this onto my cuticles and, you know, massaged it in, moisturized everywhere. And this was basically all I did, you all. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please don't forget to give a big thumbs up. Let me know how I did for my first time, and I will see you guys in my next one. I love you guys so much and have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye. Say I want you to be mine.